Welcome to Eastern Florida Baseball.
It is some picture-perfect weather for some NJCAA baseball here at Bruce Bochy Field this afternoon. Your Eastern Florida State College Titans taking on their rivals from right up I-95, the Daytona State Falcons. Good afternoon and welcome to Melbourne, everybody. Alongside Mike Parsons, I'm Jeff Radcliffe. So glad to have you along for Titans baseball here on WEFS. And the Titans coming down to the final stretch of this regular season. Playoffs are within sight, but a Daytona State team that is ripe for the pick and a team that they need to beat here in the next couple of days.
Yeah, definitely. You know, 9 games to go. We're right there in the hunt for a postseason appearance. So, you know, today's a good big day. Saylan Perry on the mound today for the Titans. You know, he's coming back from injury, but one of the aces on the staff.
He will be going up against Bryce Roth, the right-hander, the sophomore out of Seminole, Florida, 6'3", big guy, has had some struggles in the ERA department, but coming off a pretty strong start.
Yeah, he last start against Miami-Dade, he allowed just one earned run over 5 innings. You know, the thing about him is his ERA is high, but he's only allowed 4 extra base hits. So, you know, he doesn't give up the big hit, doesn't give up the big runs, but we'll see what happens today.
Titans will counter with a huge prospect in Zaylan Perry, the sophomore out of Winter Haven, transfer from UAB, looking for bigger things once he leaves Eastern Florida. A lot of scouts to watch what he can do.
Yeah, for sure. There's some scouts in the stands today with some radar guns out. We're going to see, you know, 90-94 usually on the fastball. He has a slider as well. So it'll be interesting. Last start was his first start after coming off an injury, so this is start number 2.
He'll face a formidable lineup that's batting .295 as a team. Adam Parzich will lead things off, the sophomore out of Tallahassee Lincoln. Connor Sullivan in the 2 hole. Xavier Lopez out of Oviedo High School over in the Orlando area, batting .407, leads the team in pretty much every offensive category. Nate Cannizzaro, Brett Corbett, Scott Edwards, 4 through 6. And rounding out the order, William Rawlings, the freshman infielder from Ponte Vedra, getting a start. Mike Bumgardner is the designated hitter. And Jackson Janilla, the catcher, will try to turn that order back up to Parzich. So taking these warm-up pitches here before we get started. Roth, again, 8 starts this season. Got a decent defense behind him when he goes, but that will be obviously the next inning. Zaylan Perry kind of warming up. Both teams blue and white, at
always.
Least today. Of course, Daytona wearing the black.
Yeah, so it'll be interesting here. You know, as Zaylan Perry warms up, the defense behind Perry is one of the better. You know, we're 3rd in the Region 8 in fielding percentage, so they can really pick it out there behind him.
So he'll be pitching to Luke Lambert behind the dish, Ryan Cerrone, Hector Mangual, Carlos Cadero giving it another go this season at 2nd, Adrian Dominguez at 1st, outfield left to right, Jeff Davis, Kevin Smith, and Laheem Bell. Titans coming in overall 20-20 this season in conference play. Want to get that over .500 the next couple of games. Didn't you say that coach really wanted to get that, you know, get about 7 wins here to make sure you make the playoffs?
Yeah, so we got 3 more weeks, so 9 more conference games left. He's hoping, you know, 7-2 area would get him in the playoffs. So he's right there in the mix. As you can tell, the middle of this Citrus Conference is very tight, so every game matters at this time of the season.
Titans 11-13 in the
Citrus Conference.
Citrus Conference, that's right. So in front of the Manatee, Sarasota, College of Central Florida, Santa Fe, Polk State, those are the teams you're trying to target. And again, you get some against the Daytona State. You finish the season with Manatee, Sarasota, and then the 3 tough ones at Miami-Dade as well. They'll close the season on the road there, but you want to get as many now as you can.
Yeah, for sure.
So here's Parzich. Zaylan Perry will offer his first pitch as a strike right down the middle.
Yeah, good start. Getting ahead early.
Parzich getting out of Tallahassee, Lincoln, sophomore. 6-game hit streak he's riding. Take that one high, a ball, 1-1. Boy, a lot of juice on that, but swing and a miss, strike 2.
Attaboy, attaboy.
that's the pitch there. He wasn't really getting over the plate on Saturday, so it's good to see early he's getting
right
that
now,
one
let's
going.
Go. Let's go.
Marzic batting 375. Healthy.
Good.
Fires that one back and will stay 1-2. Leads the team in runs scored with 39, so he get on base. He's a guy that can move. Three stolen bases. This is a good hitting team from Daytona State. What's been lacking is the pitching and the defense.
Yeah, it really is. And Parzic has been up top all season, and he's the catalyst on a six-game hitting streak right now. So
Parzic takes that one inside a ball. Count even at 2-2. And takes a cut, sends it deep to center. Going back is Smith, tracks it down, and there's one away.
Kevin Smith's been really solid in center field all season. Really can run it down out there.
One away, that brings out Connor O'Sullivan. The lefty, redshirt freshman, second baseman out of Venice. Transfer from Stetson, so the former Hatter coming in 306 into this conference game. He's been hot, 5 of 11 last week. So you get the righty on lefty matchup here.
Once again, really good start for Zaylin. Gets ahead.
One weak chopper to first, gobbled up by Dominguez. He'll do that one unassisted. And there are two away. Xavier Lopez, three batter in the order out of Oviedo High School, former Lion, about 45 minutes down the road from here. Leads the team in batting average, 407, 10 doubles, 6 home runs, 35 RBIs. Has hit 6 in his last 7. But he's got 2 out.
Yeah, this is definitely the guy you got to be careful with if you're Zaylin Perry.
Ball.
Ahead in the count, 1-0 is Lopez. Daytona State snapped an 8-game losing streak with a 15-2 domination over Miami-Dade on Saturday. Well, this is one of those 8-game streaks. Those are the ones that feel real good to put to bed.
Yeah, and it was.
And Howe with a 15-2 win to really come out of the slump.
I was going to say, and you know, we're facing them the next week, but it's nice that Miami-Dade gets a loss as well as we're chasing them in the standings.
Get in the zone, let's go.
There's a strike, 2-1. Zaylin just lasted 2 innings in his return outing from injury, so really just trying to work back into form here. It'll be interesting to see how far that Coach Brown keeps him in today.
Yeah, well, if he keeps throwing like this, he's going to be in for a decent outing for sure. Coming off an oblique injury, he missed about 3-4 weeks, so you know, just getting back going. But a big piece for the Titans as they try to get back into the postseason mix.
One chopped.
I like that.
Right side, foul ball. Stays 2-2.
Good pull.
Barrier auction fires, chopped. Towards shallow right field. Under it is Bell. He's got it. 3 up, 3 down in the top of the first for Daytona State. And the Titans will come to the bat for the first time in the home half. Let's take a look at the lineup. Eastern Florida. Carlos Cordero leads things off. Guy that leads the team in runs, home runs, and stolen bases. You can get him aboard. You got Cerrone and Mangual, who can really light it up from behind the plate behind him. Adrian Dominguez as well. He has some home run power and 30 RBIs to lead the team. Luke Lambert, Laheem Bell, 5 and 6 hole hitters. Followed by Jake Cooper, Kevin Smith, the Louisville transfer, and Jeff Davis will round out the order, the left fielder, who has started 10 straight games in the outfield. Try to bring him back. Defensively, here for Daytona State, Jackson Janilla is the catcher. Connor O'Sullivan in at third. Nate Cannizzaro, Rawlings, and Corbett left to right across the infield. And in the outfield, Parzic, Edwards, and Xavier Lopez. I've got the shades, shade umbrellas out. No rain in the forecast, unlike yesterday. This was a game that was initially scheduled for Thursday, but.
Yeah, and it really came down Thursday around game time. Right.
Good call. Nothing like a Friday out, getting a good start to your weekend, a little baseball. So there's Bryce Roth finishing up his warm-up pitches with a right-hander. And eight starts this season has only allowed four extra base hits. So you got a nickel and dime him to beat him.
Yeah, for sure. You know, it's 32 strikeouts and 32 and a third innings as well. So, you know, he can get the strikeout. Doesn't give up hard contact. So it'll be interesting to see how today goes.
Carlos Cordero will lead things off. Sophomore out of Kissimmee, product of the Central Point Academy, batting 309. He's hit safely in five of the last six games. It's the first meeting of the season between these two conference rivals. The Falcons do lead the all-time series 6-5. First pitch upstairs, a ball from Bryce Roth. Make it 2-0. Hitters count here to start.
Yeah, and Cordero really is the catalyst for this offense. You know, when he gets on, he's always a threat to steal and makes things happen.
Right up the middle, he will do just that. So the man with 20 stolen bases will take the long turnaround first, and now good opportunity here for Eastern Florida to get some things going early in the inning.
Yeah, and this is going to be one of the interesting things. You know, the Titans are tied for sixth in stolen bases this season, but Daytona's among the best at throwing out runners, so Junila's really good at holding them on.
Yeah, they've thrown out seven of them.
Yeah, so this is going to be an interesting little battle inside the game.
Second in the state in runners caught stealing.
So when you saw Cerrone there looking to bunt. Coach Brown loves to play small ball. Get the runner over and then hit him in. So not surprised that Cerrone was showing bunt there.
Yeah, play a little California baseball. It's what Stephen Brown likes.
Definitely.
Station to station. Manufacture the runs when you can. Cerrone batting 302. Won't be batting there. They may have him.
They do.
They got him. Out at second. Caught stealing Cordero from going from first to second, and there's one away. So I hate to say it, Mike Parsons kind of telegraphed what was going to happen. It's all his fault. Just kidding. Just go show how good of a scout you are. Roth has had a tough time locating, but got that one over.
Yeah, that was a good pitch there. Off speed. Now he's ahead against Cerrone.
Eighth runner caught stealing this season. That one gobbled up at short by Cannizzaro on to first. Corbett gloves it for out number two. And it comes down to Hector Mangual. Transfer out of Mizzou, Orlando native. Batting 364, leading the Titans this season.
He's already had a pretty good day. He signed with the University of South Alabama this morning.
How about that, Tusa?
Yeah. So,
congratulations to Hector. Not too far to travel to get to that campus.
Nope.
Chops it to short. Cannizzaro able to gobble it again.
That was really a nice play by Cannizzaro.
And that's the inning. No runs on a hit, runner thrown out, and after one, 0-0 between Daytona State and Eastern Florida State College. All right, no score after one here at Bruce Bochy Field between Daytona State and Eastern Florida. And the Falcons will bring up 4 through 6 in the order. Cannizzaro, Corbett, and Edwards to face Zaylin Perry, who had a pretty good first inning, getting out of the inning 1-2-3.
Yeah, definitely. Threw 14 pitches, 10 were strikes, so that's a good sign. After his last outing wasn't that way at all, so it's a good sign for Zaylin as we get started here.
Cannizzaro will start things off.
Another dangerous hitter for Daytona State.
Out of St. Pete, he'll come plateward now. They have a number of left-handed hitters in their lineup. Sullivan, Corbett will be coming up next. Cannizzaro righty. Three for four, four runs in Saturday's win against Miami-Dade. So looking to continue his hot hitting. I'll take that one for a strike from Zaylin Perry.
Ball.
I want a ball.
Good movement, though. He's got a lot of movement on all of his pitches right now. And really keeping him off balance.
So 1-1. Popped up and straight back.
One, two.
Jose.
Count evens up at 2-2. Top of the second here in Melbourne.
Nice pitch there.
Boy, got him off speed. First strikeout of this game for Zaylin Perry.
And that's just a really good mix between the fastball and the slider there. That's a nice pitch on a 2-2 count.
On the left side of the plate comes Brett Corbett out of Callahan, Florida, Eagles View High. Batting 326, does have a 5-game hit streak. Well, not extended there as it's right at Dominguez for the putout.
Hey, wasted no time, took the first pitch and lined it right to Dominguez.
Now, if you're the starting pitcher, you like that. One
for
pitch
sure.
Outs.
Yeah, one pitch outs are good.
Hitting coaches don't like those.
No, the Daytona side can't be happy with that at bat.
Two away brings in Scott Edwards out of Canterbury High School in Fort Myers, squares to bunt and takes a strike. Batting 254, sophomore center fielder.
Also been pretty hot lately. Couple multi-hit games in the past four.
Got to get one to get two. And right now he is behind in the count, 0-2.
Yeah, and as good as Perry looked in the first inning, he looks even better here in the second. He's really, really looking like he's settling in now.
It's a sign. Lambert sets up outside. Chop foul.
You okay?
Yeah.
See if you can get him to chase here, something ugly. On deck is William Rawlings. Should Edwards fight back and get aboard here with an 0-2 count.
It's a good pitch.
Ooh, tough one to lay off.
That was just what you were talking about, give him something to think about there.
Right.
And he did actually hold off, so 1-2 now.
1-2.
Ball, two strikes. So yeah, you gotta be. Gonna be brave. The 1-2, got him. Second strikeout, both coming in this inning, and they go down in order, 1-2-3. In the middle of two, it is Eastern Florida nothing, Falcons nothing.
Yeah, and once again, Perry throwing strikes. Two strikeouts in the inning.
Yep, had to kind of change him up a little bit.
So through two innings, 25 pitches, 18 of them are strikes, so it's really good to see.
That's a pretty good ratio.
Yeah.
Looking around to see if there's radar guns. I saw some college scouts, it looked like, in the parking lot. I saw Florida Gulf Coast was one. Pretty regular occurrence, though, here at Bruce Bochy Field to see a lot of those scouts.
Yeah, it really
is. Coming.
A lot of talent, both in our conference and on our team, so it's not unusual to see five or six major league scouts and college scouts both at the same time, especially when somebody like Perry's on the mound. He has lots of options after this season.
Right. You can never have enough pitching.
And that's kind of what the Titans have seen, you know, the last month or so, is our pitching depth has been really light, and so it's cost us some games. So good to see Perry back on the mound throwing strikes.
Adrian Dominguez will start things off here for the Titans in the home half of the second. University of Miami transfer. He's playing in his hometown of Miami, batting 315. Big RBI guy in this lineup, committed to the University of New Orleans.
Oh gosh!
Tough thing for Canizaro to gobble up, able to do so.
Yeah, he's already got
three putouts now.
I was going to say, he's already got three putouts today, and Roth is really pitching well. Early on here, he's throwing strikes, keeping the guys off balance, and doing a nice job.
Yeah, allowed this to the one hit, but that was erased on the caught stealing, so relying on the defense. Here's Luke Lambert, 5'9 sophomore out of McDonald, Pennsylvania, transfer from University of Pittsburgh. Batting 319, he's committed to the University of Delaware, so a future Blue Hen. Tries to go other way with that one, fouls it off, and he's in the hole here.
Yeah, once again, Roth really looking good. Getting ahead in the counts.
A piece of that. We'll send it deep to left, and to the wall it goes. Should be extra bases here for Lambert, who's in standing up with a double. So a one-out double for Mr. Lambert, and the Titans are in business here in the second.
Yeah, his seventh double of the season. Runs really well for a catcher. And
that's a bonus if you get a catcher that can run a little bit.
Yeah, definitely.
No stolen bases, though.
Nope.
Just let the bat do the work. Here's Laheem Bell. Saw a lot of him last year on this team. Takes off speed. Ball one.
Yeah, and Bell's one that's really come around as the season's progressed. Started out slow, but his bat's really been the contributor here as the season has gone on.
Up to 333 for the Vero Beach product. Goes opposite field there, and it will land fair ball. That should bring in a run. Lambert comes around to score. It's 1-0, and Bell in there with a stand-up double. And the RBI.
Back-to-back doubles. That one a little unconventional, but hit the chalk down the right field line and kept right on motoring into second.
So trade places with him. Now Jake Cooper will try to continue this inning with one away. One on and one in. Bell with the lead at second. Cooper takes that one. Inside a ball. Jake out of State College, Pennsylvania, transfer from Penn State. So he stayed right at home initially. Batting 267, committed to the University of West Florida after he leaves Eastern Florida. Takes a strike, 1-1.
Yeah, he's going to a really good baseball program in West Florida, so that's going to be good for him.
Tries to go opposite with that. Makes it a ball, two strikes. Kevin Smith on deck, who has been really hot lately. If you get Cooper aboard, you can really put a big number up this inning. Throwing it back. Not going to trouble Bell too much. Laheem with two stolen bases.
Yeah, I was going to say, he wasn't too far off the bag there.
Roth checks back and
hits him.
So now there's two on the hit by pitch. Two on, one out, and here comes Kevin Smith. Talk about Jay and Silent Bob, but his bat has not been silent as of late. Seven for this last 15, and now is a runner in scoring position with just one away.
Yeah, he's been really swinging it well lately. Seven for his last 15. Comes up here in a big spot for the Titans.
Out of Port St. Lucie, transfer from Louisville. Squares to bunt. Chops it down on a bouncer. That would get the runners over. So the sacrifice is there for Mr. Smith.
And there's that small ball.
Yep, moves the runners over.
So now second and third, two down.
And one hit should put you up a couple of runs here, as brings up the bottom of the order in Jeff Davis out of Assumption, Illinois. 5'10 freshman batting 288.
He's really taken over the left field spot. Early in the season, there was a few players that would play there, but the last 10, he started and left and really done a good job. And
yeah,
been hitting well.
Come in, please.
Make somebody take it from him. He's ahead in the count, 1-0. Runners at second, third, in the form of Bell and Lambert.
Good pitch there from Roth. Who, as much as this inning's gone on, he's basically one out away from getting out of it here. If he can get out with just the one run, he'd have to call that a win at this point.
Pops this one back on the infield, shading his eyes and unable to grab it. So a missed opportunity there.
Yeah, that's
for Corbett.
He lost his hat about halfway in the run, and then that sun, boy, that's a tough sky.
Yeah, he's looking straight up at it. Yeah, those hats come in handy.
Yeah. Long run, big sky, not a good combination.
A new life here for Davis. Ball a strike, ball two strikes, rather. Get bat on it again, pop it under. This time the hat stays on, and Corbett's got it to end the inning. But one run scores on two hits. There were two runners left. And after two, it is Eastern Florida 1, Daytona State nothing.
The lab that EFSC respiratory program has is very up to date and had actually more stuff than some of the hospitals did. As a student here, you know, working with all that equipment definitely puts you at an advantage, because when you're here for a semester and then you go out, you get to see it on real patients. The lab here is, I would say, above and beyond what you would need to see and what you need to know when you go out to your clinical sites.
All right, to the top of the third we go here at Bruce Bochy Field.
Yeah, the bottom of the order now for Daytona coming up. Zalen's six up, six down so far here for Perry.
Yeah, he'll take that. Face the minimum if you can.
Offense gave him a 1-0 lead. Let's see how he comes out here in the third.
Bottom third of the order coming up for Daytona and Rawlings, Bumgardner and Janilla. So Rawlings was a surprise entrant to that starting lineup.
Yeah,
that played much, but batting 217.
Coach must have had a feeling this morning, so get a chance to see how that is now.
7 runs, 6 RBIs on the season out of Ponte Vedra, Providence High. Freshman. And getting the start at second base for his defensive work, obviously. And takes a strike here from Perry.
Hey, don't do
make that
much.
A ball.
Stay loose.
Beg your pardon.
Stay loose, trust it.
Yeah, it was a close pitch, just a little low there.
Just misses that one, too. So ahead in the count is Rawlings here.
Hey, reset, reset, we're good.
DH Mike Bumgardner is on deck.
Ball.
Oh, 3-0. Gonna have to come in now.
Yeah, just missing the first three there, so. See what he throws here.
There's a strike. Taken all the way was Rawlings.
Yeah.
Ball.
And ball four. So walks him on 5. First walk issued this afternoon by Perry. And runner aboard for the first time. And now Mike Bumgardner does split the DH spot a lot with Sebastian Grafmeyer, who's not in the lineup this afternoon. Hasn't hit in his last 4. Be a good time to get one now. Takes upstairs. Sophomore DH out of Cocoa. And started at Merritt Island High School, so a former Mustang here, yep, trying to do some damage against the hometown team. Runner thought about going, and down the line, foul ball. Bumgardner, good-looking hitter.
Tyson.
Yeah, that was a good swing there. Just a little in front of it. Pulled it foul.
Hey, win the 1-1. Win the 1-1.
Looks like he gets a hold of one. Look at how he's,
yeah,
he's got the cut. Throwback. Nothing doing. Rawlings, no stolen bases to speak of this year.
No, but definitely looks like he's looking to run.
Swing and a miss from Bumgardner. Ball 2 strikes. Oh, you're going to see a DH try to butt him over. I don't know. Hasn't squared yet. And gets under it. Pops it up to short. Settling under and getting the put out is Mangual. And Rawlings will stay there at first. The bottom of the order. 9-hole hitter, Jackson Janilla out of St. Cloud, Harmony High School. Not too far down the road from here in Melbourne.
Nope.
Struggled a bit recently. Did collect a hit in his last game, batting 328. Throwback, not in time to nail Rawlings.
Perry definitely keeping an eye on him over at first, though. Getting a good lead again.
Could use a double play ball here if you're Eastern Florida. And taking a strike, 0-2.
Hey, come on, need another one, need another one.
I reckon sound the count, so it's a no balls, 1 strike. Couple of throwbacks. Here's stretching the pitch. Misses upstairs, 1-1.
Hey, 1-1-1, let's go.
Yeah, this inning Perry is getting it a little higher, getting more.
Higher pitch count a little bit. Janello waits, runner goes, ball's in the dirt, and safe. The appeal there, I thought he might have gotten back before he got in into the bag there, but.
One, two.
So a stolen base for
his
Rawlings,
first
of the season.
He looked like he was ready to go, so.
What's
sure enough,
the call there?
He took off right as soon as it went. Ball beat him. It was just on the wrong side of the plate, or wrong side of the bag.
Yeah, throw kind of bounced there. A better throw, that probably has him. Well, Janilla with a runner in scoring position. Just one out. And that will poke through. What a good piece of hitting there. Coming around to score is Rawlings. We are tied at one on the single to right from Jackson Janilla.
Yeah, so big stolen base from Rawlings. Turns into a run.
So the walk comes back to haunt.
Yeah. Nice piece of hitting by Jackson Janilla.
And now you've turned the order over, the top. So batting for the second time is now one of your heavy hitters, Adam Parzich.
Yes.
He flied out to center his first time at bat.
That was a really good pitch there. He got him to commit. Got ahead, strike one.
Rest that bat on the shoulder. Goes low for it, pokes it through the hole to left. That will keep the inning going. Just one base on the advancement from Junilla. So a one out single for Parzich. Extends that hitting streak to seven.
Lambert gonna go out and have a quick word with Perry as the meat of the order for Daytona is coming up now.
And it is a meaty one at that. O'Sullivan, the Stetson transfer now.
And then Lopez behind him.
Grounded out to first. First time up, can do some damage here. Two runners on and one out. Swing and fouls it off, 0-1.
See if Perry and the Titans can do like Daytona did in the bottom of the second and get out of this jam with just the one run.
Perry checks the runner. Multiple times, stretches, pitches, and brings it for a strike. Sullivan in an 0-2 hole.
Yeah, it's a big pitch there. 0-2 now on O'Sullivan. He can throw his pitch now and try to get him to chase.
Sullivan with 24 RBIs, the throwback. In time. There's Janilla there at second. Time. Hat blew or something into the. What that was. A little breeze going left to right here this afternoon. There's the 0-2. Upstairs, a ball.
1-2.
Try to get him to chase a high one there.
Zalen have to do a little bit more work here this inning. Ball two, count even. Two balls, two strikes on Sullivan, or O'Sullivan.
Good eye from O'Sullivan there. Taking a couple of close pitches.
Hey, deep breath, let's go.
Evens things up at 2-2 now.
Sullivan running a three-game hit streak.
Ball.
And now runs the count full.
Full count.
Getting a little more concerning with each pitch here. Fisted. It's going to drop for a base hit. They'll hold the runners, and the bases are loaded and full of Falcons on the single from O'Sullivan.
So three straight singles. Daytona has things going now with their best hitter coming up.
As Xavier Lopez sits safely in six of his last seven, and they're going to discuss this because you got a guy coming to the plate that's hitting 407 with six home runs.
Yeah, pitching coach Tyson Ellis going out, probably just going to calm him down a little bit.
We talked in the open about how important it is you get wins here against the team that's bringing up the rear in the conference. Don't want to be giving up a big number in any inning to where you're playing from behind the whole game.
Yeah, for sure. They really have to minimize this, if not get out of it all the way. You know, the Titans are good at turning double plays, so that's what they really need here. Although Lopez is probably not the right hitter for that to come up, but.
The Oviedo man, do some damage here for Daytona State if you can get a bat on it. And able to get some metal to it. Tracking back and dropping it was Cordero. Only run will come across because everybody kind of had to hold. But the inning will continue and the run will score. Daytona State takes the lead.
Yeah, that was such a tough play. Cordero usually makes that pretty easily.
So E4.
You can see he's way out. And Laheem Bell wasn't quite there yet, so Cordero just kept coming back on it.
Was it the sun or maybe a little bit of the breeze that was deal?
I think it was a little bit of both. Kind of guided away from him a little bit. Now the officials are having a conference.
So everybody's safe. So were they appealing for the field fly or something? Yeah.
So, yep, that's what they
did.
Yeah,
the infield fly rule.
So they called the infield fly rule.
So batter is out.
But the run will score on the one base for everybody.
So two away, most importantly, for Eastern Florida. But Ducks on the pond, second and third for Daytona State. And another heavy hitter in Nate Cannizzaro. 387. 3-for-4 in that win against Miami-Dade. And chops it to right. It's going to be a tough play, but Bell is on it to end the inning. But two runs come across on three hits plus the error. And there were two left. And it is 2-1 Daytona State Falcons as we go to the home half of the third. Back in Melbourne, the Titans have conceded the lead 2-1, but it could have been a lot worse if it weren't for the infield fly or the right field fly rule that was in effect there.
Yeah, that was an interesting call for sure, because Cordero backpedaled quite a ways into right field before he got to that ball, but worked out well for the Titans as they got out of that jam.
Yeah, sometimes those are the breaks. Still concede the run, but it could have been a lot worse. Now, top of the order here for Eastern Florida, try to get back on level terms. Carlos Cordero was victimized by that fly rule. Trying to atone for it here, takes that one way high a ball.
Yeah, so if you're Roth, you want a quick inning now that they've given you the lead. Try to get right back to the bats if you could.
Heading's the count 2-0. I think sometimes you're a pitcher, you have a long inning that you're waiting out. You come out there, now you're a little cooled off.
Yeah.
You've been waiting a bit.
Not quite as sharp as you were.
Three. Oh, got that one to drop in. All right.
2-1.
That looked like ball all the way until it dropped.
Yeah. Yeah, he's got some late movement on those pitches for sure.
3-2. Swung right through it. Cordero singled the lead off the game in the first and then was caught stealing. Not sure he's going to make it the first this time. He will, though, on the bad throw.
Yeah, slow roller there, so gave Cordero a chance. Cordero got up the line well and forced the shortstop to make a quick throw, and first baseman couldn't quite glove it.
Score is an error on that, on the throw. So, runner aboard here. Cordero on for the second time. Cerrone will square to bunt.
That's a pretty good
one. It. Yeah, that will get the job done, and he'll just wait for the tag. Cordero on to second on the sacrifice. So one away, and Hector Mangual on the runner in scoring position now, and just the one out.
Mangual's been one of the Titans' best pitchers. Wow, Cordero on the
runner
jump there.
Runner goes and in there, standing without a throw that time. No doubt about it. Cordero with the stolen base.
He made sure he wasn't getting caught on that one.
No way. It's his 21st swipe of the season. And now he's at third. It's 90 feet away from tying this game. Chopper up the middle. Picked up by Cannizzaro. Throw on to first. But the runner will score, and we're tied at one. Cordero comes down, the RBI goes to Mangual.
So stolen base leads to a run right there. Titans aggressive play, ties the game up.
And now the smooth operator comes in, love that walk-up music. Boy, you gotta, that's some, you got to have some bones to do that one. That's good.
You have to be hitting 315 13 doubles if you're going to come up with that.
Oh, Sade, Adrian Dominguez. When that song probably predates him by a couple of decades.
Yeah.
That's good. Dominguez grounded out short. Last at bat, this one. Skies rockets it to the fence, and it is gone! A home run! Dominguez! His third home run to lead the team this year now. And it's a two-run shot in the Titans. For the solo shot, and that will give the Titans a 3-2 lead.
At first, it kind of looked like he might have gotten just under it, but boy, that ball carried.
Just up there and up there, and then cleared the bar. 3-2.
Oh, good play by the
shortstop.
How about
that? They were able to get him the stretch, and that's the inning, but not before a little damage. Solo home run followed by the run, tying run scored with a little station-to-station ball, and the Titans lead it 3-2. Go to the fourth.
Yeah, wow. You got all that one, actually. Yeah, that's.
The lab that EFSC respiratory program has is very up to date and had actually more stuff than some of the hospitals did. As a student here, you know, working with all that equipment definitely puts you at an advantage, because when you're here for a semester and then you go out, you get to see it on real patients. The lab here is, I would say, above and beyond what you would need to see and what you need to know when you go out to your clinical sites.
Well, Daytona State went from a run up to a run down in the span of one inning. Each team in that third plating two. Offense is starting to come alive here as we go to the top of the fourth. It will be the 5-6-7 hitters in Corbett, Edwards, and Rawlings scheduled to hit here against Perry. Zalen had to do a little bit more work that last inning. Let's see if we can get it back to keeping it to the minimum.
Yeah, for sure. The Daytona strung together some singles and put some real pressure on the Titans defense in that last inning. Bottom of the third saw the Titans play a little bit of everything. Saw small ball to score the first run and then long ball for the second run.
Dominguez with a home run, his third of the season. That leads the team. This has not been a team this year that's done it with the long ball.
Yeah, for sure. They play to their field. This is one of the bigger fields in Region 8, and Coach Brown has definitely catered the team to that. And
right. You're going to play half your games here. You might as well, yeah. The Dodger Stadium of the Citrus Conference.
That's right.
Perry delivers upstairs a ball. Let's get another look at Brett Corbett. Corbett put out three unassisted at his first at bat, trying to extend that nine-game hit streak. There's a strike, 1-1. Batting 326. Oh, just painted the lower corner there. 1-2.
Yeah, that's a really good pitch. Not much a hitter's going to do with that pitch.
Yeah, other than foul it off.
Yeah.
Goes opposite field. That will be a base hit. So a 10-game hit streak now for Brett Corbett of Daytona State. And more importantly, it's a leadoff single here in the top of the fourth.
Yeah, these last couple innings, Daytona's really good, done a good job of finding pitches they can handle and getting hits, putting some pressure on the Titans.
Corbett, a 326 average, but hitting 500 now in his last 11 at-bats. Last 10 games now.
Big swing there.
Perry ahead of the count. Runner at first, nobody out. Some fires, and that one outside a ball. Love this time of year here, right? April, it's a nice warm day, but not too hot. You don't mind sitting out and taking it all in, hence the 2 o'clock first pitch.
Yeah, it really is. This is the time of year that you love to live in Florida.
That's going to soon change, but.
Yeah.
Yes. Got him on that one.
Yeah, that's another strikeout for Zalen Perry.
Is his third.
Really good pitch.
One away. Fooled him a bit on that one.
Looked much sharper today than he did his first start back.
Here's Rawlings, who led off the last inning by getting on board on a base on balls, then getting a stolen base and coming around to score.
Yeah, his first stolen base was a big one for him. Got things going for Daytona State.
Hey, watch your hands. Let's go.
Squares the butt. And that will get the runner anyway. So Corbett over. Second on the pass ball.
That pitch is just moving so much. Lambert couldn't corral it. So now Rawlings comes up, runner in scoring position.
Got his first stolen base. Can he get his first RBI? I'm not his first. Rawlings does have six coming in. To match his jersey number.
Couldn't hold on that. Strike one.
Balls and a strike. Runner at second is Corbett. Ooh, jammed him. Did he go? He did. 2-2. Can't turn on that.
Yeah, that pitch there, that's a hard one to stay off, but you're not going to get the bat around on it either.
It's one you'll hit with your fist if you get lucky. Straight back. Stays 2-2. Corbett, if you were wondering, the runner at second. No stolen bases yet this year. But we said the same thing about Rawlings.
Yeah.
Swing and a miss, strike three. Fourth strikeout here for Zaylen Perry.
Second of the inning.
But still at second, here comes Mike Bumgardner, sophomore designated hitter out of Merritt Island. Swung right through that one.
Perry looks like he's finding that groove that he had in the first and second inning again now. Really starting to throw strikes again.
Threw that one right on by, and it's quickly a ball, two strikes. End this inning after giving up that leadoff single. And it does just that. Strikes out Bumgardner, his fifth K of this game. And we go to the home half, the fourth. The Titans leading it 3-2.
Yeah, that's just really a good pitch there. He's not much chance for the hitter to make contact with that one.
A sweeping look across campus, a little breeze blowing. Here on the Melbourne campus of Eastern Florida State College. Seems like every time I come here, the campus changes just a little bit. There's just little additions here and there that make the school better.
Yeah, and we broke ground on a new technology center last week. It's going to go over by the King Center where we're seeing now. So, yeah, it's... seems like
it's almost unrecognizable from 10 years ago.
It really is, and it just keeps growing and growing. So it's Dr. Ritchie's done a great job of continuing a master plan, and we just keep growing.
Athletic facilities keep improving too each time you come out. Some of the best in the state. We're going to see the softball field, only a couple of years old. We'll see that here on Tuesday in a doubleheader for the Titans.
Yeah, that should be a really fun doubleheader. Miami-Dade's really good, so that should be really fun.
Yeah, Shelby Pettick's team, what, 15-15 in conference, 31-17 overall?
Yep.
They'll be playing St. Pete, 1-3. We'll have both games for you here on WEFS. Actually,
nope, we play St. Pete Saturday.
Yeah, St. Pete is Saturday, and then Miami-Dade is who we'll have here live. Yeah, correct.
Yep.
But in good position to make the postseason?
Yeah, yeah, just like baseball, you know, just got to finish strong and work their way in. So it's exciting. All of our teams are heading into the postseason, hopefully.
Yeah. Offer congratulations, too, to former men's basketball coach Jeremy Schulman, who takes the Division I job at Tennessee Martin after, what, eight seasons here? 14 seasons. Taking the basketball program to new heights. So congratulations to Coach Schulman. And
Yeah, for
sure. He's gonna leave the program in a much better place than it was, and whoever's taken over has a cushy job.
Yeah.
Bell will pop this up to lead things off and flies out the center where Scott Edwards was waiting for it.
Oddly enough, the first out recorded to the outfield, so.
Really, yes.
Roth has really done a nice job keeping it on the ground, except for Dominguez, of course.
Jake Cooper rolls that one back. He is hit by a pitch, advanced to second, back in the second inning. Was stranded there. Batting 267 coming in and quickly behind 0-2 here to Bryce Roth. Reaches out and gets it. And settling, Lopez is got it in right field. So a fly out to center, and that followed by a fly out to right. And here's Kevin Smith. With two away, Kevin Smith. Port St. Lucie native.
Sacrifice bunt in his first at bat.
Takes that one upstairs, a ball.
A lot of break on that ball.
Mm-hmm.
It was inside, but that was a big bender there.
Advantageous count here for Smith.
Throws another one.
Got that one to go.
Ball.
Takes upstairs, 3-1. Two outs here in the bottom of the fourth.
Daytona does have somebody warming up, starting to get ready over there.
Ball.
Ooh, that was close.
And he walked him. So a two out walk to Kevin Smith brings up Jeff Davis.
Smith also a real threat to steal.
First walk issued by
Daytona's coach, Tim Tuma, out to have a chat.
And give some more time to the bullpen to get their warm up in. Maybe get through this inning and then make the change.
Yeah, he got two quick outs, so. Pitch count's not really that high, so
no.
It's just a matter of him throwing strikes and getting outs here.
Number 9 hitter Jeff Davis flied out to first base last time up.
He's just missed with that one again. It's around the plate, just not quite getting the calls.
Runner goes.
That's a great jump.
And unable to get a throw in. Stolen base for Smith. Be his 18th of the season.
Yeah, another really good jump.
And now runner in scoring position here for Davis, but two out. 1-1 the count. Thought about the pick off the stretch from Roth. And the pitch. Gets it through, base hit. They'll send him. And a two out RBI single for Jeff Davis.
Really nice piece of hitting there. Saw the second baseman was playing for the pickoff. Big hole over there and slapped it right through.
Take another look here. Good piece of hitting. Just outside the glove of Corbett. That's what you gotta do. You score some runs with two outs. That's like bonus.
Yeah.
4-2 ball game now. Oh. Caught him in a bit of a pickle. This should get him out of the inning, and it does, but not before the Titans can play to run on the one hit. There was the runner caught stealing there. But 4-2, Titans, as we go to the top of the fifth here in Melbourne.
The lab that EFSC respiratory program has is very up to date and had actually more stuff than some of the hospitals did. As a student here, you know, working with all that equipment definitely puts you at an advantage, because when you're here for a semester and then you go out, you get to see it on real patients. The lab here is, I would say, above and beyond what you would need to see and what you need to know when you go out to your clinical sites.
I'm back with you at Bruce Bochy Field. Mike Parsons, Jeff Ratcliffe, and got a good one here for the Titans, and in control by two runs as we hit in these middle innings. Top of the fifth now. We'll start with the bottom of the order and Junilla. And got to like that Perry gonna had that one little shaky inning, but rebounded pretty nicely in the last one.
Yeah, he really has looked good for most of the game today, playing into the fifth inning. Coach Brown's got to like that.
There's a pitcher up in the bullpen for Eastern Florida.
Looks like Bryce Carter warming up. A little bit different this weekend with the rain out yesterday, playing right. Friday and Saturday, so you don't get a day off in between.
Yeah.
Got to manage the bullpen a little bit different.
Correct. Changes things up. Right, Janilla will start things off from the nine hole. And the third inning, he singled. An RBI came around to score, so if that's production out of the nine hole that you want.
Yeah.
Chops that one back, and it's an 0-2 count here quickly on Janilla. Two strikes.
Hi. Hit a bit. Yep.
Really good 0-2 pitch there, though.
And got him again. Six strikeouts, Nye, for Perry.
Four in a row.
That's right, four straight. He's got him guessing.
Yeah, that one just. Once again, throw it by him. Good fastball. He's had that most of the day today.
Off the hand, Rhino.
Brings up the top of the order, and Parzic, 1-for-2 with a single. Happened back in the third. The 1-0. Inside, ball two.
Yeah, that one really rode inside. Almost got him on that one.
Hey, stay close. Come through me. Time.
Time call just before he hit.
Yeah.
Had to hold that one up.
That was about as late as they'll get one, probably.
Three and one.
Come on,
plateward right over Perry. That will be a base hit for Parzic. His second, so he's 2 for 3. Good piece of hitting up the middle.
Yeah, for sure. Bouncing ball just over Perry in the center field.
Brings Sullivan up. Also had a hit in his last at bat. One away here, top of the fifth. And the Falcons down a couple of runs, but have that lineup to be able to really close the gap quickly.
Yeah, especially the ones coming up. Showing bunt there.
All in all, a strike.
Sullivan's 1 for 2 today.
4-game hit streak now for the man from Venice.
Good pitch. Oh, yes, that
on
corner.
A strike.
Yep.
0-2. Good pitch.
So Perry got behind Parzic, but right back to 0-2 here.
Yep.
On O'Sullivan.
Yeah, I'm not playing around. Modest lead here for Parzic. Take that one a ball. Okay, taking all the way. 1-2.
1-2.
O'Sullivan, as you mentioned, had that hit back in the third. He's got 11 multi-hit games this season. And we'll have
a 12th.
Back-to-back singles here from the top of the order as Parzic moves to second with one away.
And much like the third, Daytona just kind of stringing singles along.
Coach Brown going to have a word.
He's actually called for the bullpen, so I think we're going to see Bryce Carter now. I said, second start back from the injury. This was a good outing for Perry, but I think that's going to be it.
Yeah, 4.1 innings pitched on this outing.
Yep.
You leave with a lead. And let's bring in Mr. Carter. All right. So Bryce Carter, the freshman out of Seminole High School over in Sanford. 4.32 ERA will come in, making his ninth appearance, the 1-1 record. 18 walks, 20 strikeouts, I think.
Yeah.
So struggles with control at times, but.
Another hard thrower out of the pen for the
lefty
Titans.
A bit of a different look now. There's his numbers. As you said, you got a doubleheader tomorrow, right? Up
yep.
In Daytona Beach, so. Managing the staff here is optimal. Well, getting the win is optimal, but.
Yeah, and Carter's made a start. He's gone multiple innings, so Coach Brown probably hopes to get a couple out of him to bridge the gap to the back of the bullpen.
On those doubleheader days, you know you need the deep bullpen.
Yeah.
To the bullpen here for Coach Brown. And the first batter he'll face will be the one, the only Xavier Lopez.
That's a welcome to the game.
Yeah.
A couple on.
Yeah, let's go with the best
Xavier
hitters
Lopez.
In the conference. Right, right. It's just showing the trust you have in him.
Perry finishes with 6 strikeouts and 1 walk.
4 1/3. Just 3 hits. 5 hits. 5 hits.
If Carter can get out of this jam, it'll be just the 2 runs.
Yeah, he's on the hook for he's on the hook for these 2. Got one out. Got lefty on lefty here. So a good time to make the change. ball one. X-Man. Got that one in there, a strike, 1-1. Just missed.
2-1.
Two balls, one strike here on Xavier Lopez. Cracks it foul to left, 2-2. Looking for his first hit. Get him to chase. Full brings count. The count full 3-2.
Yes, sir.
Oh, come on, let's go win it.
All right, big moment in this game right here on this pitch.
Yeah, for sure.
And he walked him. Bases are loaded with one away.
Me and you.
Sullivan moves to second. Parsons over to third. And Cannizzaro now coming to the plate. Guys hitting 387 with three home runs. Comes inside a ball. Use a double play here, huh? Nope. Now pop up. Oh, it's gonna be deep enough to get one in. It will, if you catch it, they're able to do so. Coming plateward, and the run will score. It's 4-3 on the, let's just say, sacrifice fly.
Yeah, that's what a play by the center fielder Kevin Smith. I had said earlier that he runs a lot of things down, and boy, he ran that one down.
Whew.
Watch this.
Sure, who was going to get it? Who wants it? Also, it was a base hit. It dropped.
It did drop.
So the single for Cannizzaro. The bases are still loaded.
Huh.
One run in. A one-run game. Hawkins have scattered 7 hits now.
Yeah, they're definitely as advertised with the 295 team batting average.
Corbett extended that hitting streak to 10 last inning. Really do some damage here with a good swing. Fouls that one back. Much needed strike goes to 1-2.
1-2.
Just like the third inning, stringing singles together.
Foul ball. Yeah. Trying to limit the damage. That guy has been hitting 500 over his last 10 games. And gets a piece of it, pops it up. Tracking is Smith. He settles under, makes the grab. And the game will tie on the sack fly. Coming in to score is O'Sullivan. But there are two away now. Did the job, did Corbett.
I was just going to say, good piece of hitting by Corbett to make sure he got the run home with the fly ball to center.
Runner still at first and second. Now two out for Scott Edwards.
And a big out for Bryce Carter. Has to focus on Edwards and try to get out of this jam.
Back half of this lineup does not have the the same pop as far as batting average and RBIs as the first five did. Right now, as it stands, tied at four. There's a strike.
Two, he can throw what he wants now and try to get him to chase.
Bryce tries to get him to chase on that one. Ball, two strikes, two out, two on. It's plateward, swing and a miss, strike three. First strikeout for Carter, and it ends the inning, but not before two runs score on two hits. There were two left, and we are tied at four as we go to the bottom of the fifth here on WEFS. Seen four and a half innings. We go to the bottom of the fifth, tied at four between these two rivals, Eastern Florida and Daytona State. And we go to the top of the order here. Titans try to answer that two-run inning for the Falcons. Why not go, Mr. Cordero? Carlos singled. And trying to get on board quick here, but grounds out to first. Quickly retired here in the fifth.
Yeah, I was gonna say, been on both times today. Been the catalyst for the offense, but that was a hard bunt. Went down the line too much. Allowed the first baseman to get it before he could get up the line.
Yeah, reached on an error back in the third. Sacrifice, stole, and then scored. But he's Cerrone now out of Tampa's A3 Academy. Has taken over that third base spot since the injury to Brady Strelitz.
Yeah, done a really nice job stepping in.
Bit of a slump, but he broke out of it on Saturday with two hits.
Those are big shoes to fill. Brady Strelitz, one of the cornerstones of the team early in the season before he got hurt.
Any chance he gets back?
I don't believe he will be back. Shoulder issues. Good eye there.
Yeah, held off. 2-2. 2-2 the count.
And for Bryce Roth, you know, it's a new life. Now it's a 4-4 game.
It's a little spring in the step.
Good
got
pitch
him.
There.
In a knee, corner knee, yeah.
First strikeout for Roth.
Heard the ump. Corner on the knees.
And they're two away here for Mengual.
Shortstop's grounded out to shortstop both times up.
Twice. His favorite position. Did have the RBI in the second one, though. Flies that one to right center, and the right fielder Xavier Lopez has it. 1-2-3 go the Titans in the bottom of the fifth. So it stays 4-4. Go to the final three innings here. Top of the sixth coming your way next on WEFS. 4-4 between the Titans and the Falcons.
The biggest challenge that students have, I believe, is just getting started. That's why we're here at the Writing Lab, to help show them how to pre-plan their writing, how to get a good start, and then go back and revise. And we're here for every step of that. I just like to see that little eureka moment, that light bulb that goes on, and they're like, oh, I know how to do this now. I help with any class that involves writing. If it's language-based, we can help.
And we go back to the top of the sixth now. So glad to have you along here on WEFS. Jeff Radcliffe, Mike Parsons, Brian Foster on our entire WEFS crew, getting the spring season underway here. A beautiful afternoon and a good game, 4-4 right now.
Yeah, really, really well done. Really well done. Good game so far. Both starters pitched well. We find ourselves in a bullpen game here for the Titans.
The chess match. 7-8-9 here for the Falcons in the sixth. Rawlings, it's a bit of a surprise in that lineup when we first got here today.
Yeah.
He's acquitted himself well.
He definitely has.
Did strike out in his last at bat, but.
Ball.
Square bunt maybe his way on there. Rawlings out of Providence High in Ponte Vedra. Got his first stolen base of the season earlier in this game.
Scored the first run. Has definitely shown he has a good eye.
Yeah, doesn't swing at bad pitches. Second inning of work now for Bryce Carter. Held off on that one too. 3-0.
Yeah, if you're Bryce Carter, you don't want to start walking the bottom of the lineup because the top has really been good today.
Yeah. Taken all the way for a strike. Just painted the outside corner there to Carter. I want to get him to swing at this. Held off. Oh, just again got the outside corner.
I just caught the outside corner.
I mean, just.
Carter works his way back to full count.
And able to get a swing on that one.
Stayed alive.
Now you got a little bit more creativity at your fingertips. Inside, ball four. Second walk issued to Rawlings. Had a stolen base last time, so file that one away. Looks like we'll have a pinch hitter here. He's Sebastian Grafmeier. And then for Bumgardner.
So we had said that they've both been DHing, and now they're pinch hitting for one another.
Grafmeier out of Cape Coral's Ida Baker High School, hit from the right side of the plate, squaring to bunt, unable to do so. Batting 247. Three doubles, two triples, six stolen bases. That leads the team, should he get on. From your DH.
Yeah. And he doesn't look like a speedster either, no. So that's interesting.
He's ahead in the count, 2-0. Multiple hits in three of his last five games. Surprising he was left out of the lineup.
Yeah.
Is action working in the Titans bullpen, by the way. Cordero, maybe. Another square to bunt.
Ball.
And takes a ball and draws the walk.
Time.
So back-to-back base on balls issued by Carter here.
Tyson Ellis is going to go out and have a chat.
Janilla coming to the plate, and then that big top of the order coming.
And it is Anthony Cordero that's warming up. That's warming up out in the pen.
Made the call yet.
No.
Just giving them a little time. Complete the warm-up throws.
They'll let Carter face at least one more. Try to get himself righted. Coach Brown would probably like to not use Cordero for three today if he didn't have to. With two games tomorrow.
Right. It's one thing if the score line in this game was, you know, 4-1.
Right.
4-4 is a little different. You need every game.
You gotta make sure you win it before you worry about tomorrow.
There's Janilla batting for the third time. Struck out his last at bat, but is 1-for-2 at a RBI single back in the third. Come plate work. Runners on first and second. Nobody out here in the top of the sixth. Well, you want to at least get one out of this.
Yeah.
Maybe a double play. Checks the runner, stretches, pitches outside. Ball two. The bunt again.
Yeah, so
3-0.
Now 3-0 once again.
Come in.
Outside ball.
Not really close there.
Four, and he's walked the bases loaded here.
So we're going to see Anthony Cordero now with the bases loaded here in the top of the sixth. Coach has made the call.
That will close the book on Bryce Carter. Just didn't quite have the control here this afternoon, but does leave in a tie game. And you got Cordero here to try to bail him out. Anthony Cordero, typically the closer on this team out of Ocala's Trinity Catholic High. Good baseball powerhouse. 6'2 sophomore righty. 2.39 ERA.
Yeah, he's
about as nails as you got on this stuff.
He definitely is. Coming off a great outing on Saturday. He came in after Zaylin Perry struggled after two innings and seven scoreless innings, struck out nine. Joked afterwards he didn't know he was going to go seven. Thought he was going to go four or so. But
he kept putting me out there.
Right? As the closer, he just kept coming in. So. I'm sure that coach is hoping he kind of replicates that today.
31 strikeouts against five walks, so control not the issue here.
Definitely not. Another one, low 90s with the fastball. Mixes in a slider. In this kind of jam, this is the perfect guy to go to.
Because the strikeout's in play.
Get you the strikeout,
yep.
Or weak contact as well. But he's going to face the top of this lineup that's been really good so far.
But they'll be seeing him for the first time, so there's that. It'll be Parzich, who's 2 for 3. Yeah. First guy up. Studying in what he's about to see here. Again, the first meeting of the teams this season.
Cordero's going to University of Jacksonville.
A future Dolphin.
Actually committed earlier in the season. So he knew where he wanted to go right away. Right. As soon as he got the offer, he was good.
Time.
Time called. And so here's a situation that Cordero's facing. Bases loaded via 3 walks in a 4-4 game and nobody out. Strap in and good luck. Oh, got away. And one run will score there on the pass ball.
Just an inside pitch that Lambert couldn't quite glove.
And it's a 5-4 lead. A run without the benefit of a hit in this inning. Chopped left. A sure-handed defense of Eastern Florida being tested.
Yeah, the infield's playing in.
Project fouls that one off the screen.
1-2.
Two strikes now, though. Cordero definitely looking for the strikeout.
Got him. First batter, first strikeout. For Cordero.
And just out away. Front, off-speed pitch. He just got him way out front.
Smoked him.
One down.
Still two on with one out. This is Connor O'Sullivan. A couple of singles, 2 for 3. Scored back in the 5th. That precipitated the change from Perry to Carter. Down Broadway, strike.
And the pitch.
Pitch?
Yeah.
Got him on the pitch, said Greg. Love Chuck's mic placement out there. Getting everything we
that
need
is
to
a
hear.
Good one.
All the insight. Two balls and a strike.
You can also hear how hard Luke Lambert's working behind the plate.
Right. Yeah. It's not the pictures, it's also the sounds. Baseball, a game for all senses.
Ball.
Stares a ball.
Lopez lurking on deck.
Come on in.
Three-one, and got away. So a rare walk issued.
Yeah, that's something you don't usually see from Cordero.
It's his 5th of the season, that is it. And now you got Lopez up. It's like, come on, man.
Yeah, last time up, he was the one that walked.
Right.
Nowhere to put him this time.
Hasn't really done a lot of damage, but man, all it takes is one swing and. Got him inside a strike.
That border laundry?
On the corner.
Just making sure. One out, one already in, without the benefit of a hit. This is the 6th batter of the inning.
Yeah.
So the plate with a 1-1 swung on, sent to left. Under it is Davis. He's got it. Runner's going to try to score from third. And he's in there safe to make it a 6-4 ball game. So Grafmeyer in there, second run of the inning, but there are two away.
So now Cannizzaro steps in.
We're still at first and second now. Cannizzaro, the shortstop, with two out. Swing and a miss, strike one. Cannizzaro, 1-for-3. Struck out, flied out, and singled back in the fifth. Just outside. Count running up to 2-1. Cordero facing in on Cannizzaro, who will take that one. 3-1. Boy, big pitch here. And he walked him. The bases again loaded. Second walk issued for Cordero.
Just missing one of those pitches. They are close.
Yeah, it's not wild or nope. Missing big.
Come on, here.
But bases once again loaded. Daytona's had this opportunity a few times today.
Corbett will foul it straight back, first pitch. Corbett sack fly in the last inning, single in the fourth. Actually 1-for-2. It's the eighth batter this inning. Two runs in without the benefit of a hit. There's a strike. Just painted the outside. 1-2.
1-2.
Flies it deep to left. Settling. Davis has got it in that, thankfully. Ends the inning, but not before two runs score without the benefit of a hit. There were three runners left, and the Titans trail now 6-4 as we go to the bottom half of the sixth here at Bruce Bochy Field. We go to the home half of the sixth. New pitcher here for Daytona State. We get our first look at Wyatt Mummert. freshman lefty out of Cockeysville, Maryland. 6'3", that's a long way from home. 2-2, 3.97 ERA, does have 34 strikeouts. That leads the team. And now his 21st appearance.
Only 6 walks. So just like Anthony Cordero, really good control. Lots of strikeouts.
One of the better ERAs on this side as well. As a team, Daytona State's ERA, 7.21. So he's helping that out a little bit.
He is. Yeah, him and Jake Gibson are the two that come out of the pen usually when they're in the lead or in the run. And we're seeing Mummert first. I'm sure Gibson will be right behind him if this stays the same.
And the smooth operator coming back. So close the book on Roth. Dominguez had the home run back in the third. Took it over that right field wall for his third home run of the season. Just like to get on base and get something started here. Outside, 1-1 the count. Lefty on lefty. Outside of all.
Definitely a different look than what Roth was was doing. Roth had a lot of off speed, a lot of movement.
This kid's gonna come right at you. Gets a piece, sends it to center, but it should be an easy play for Edwards, and it is. Fly out 8. And there's one away for Mr. Lambert. Luke. Two previous at-bats. Double and scored in the second, and then grounded out to short in the third.
Yeah, he got the first run of the game with the first of a pair of doubles back-to-back, him and Laheem Bell, so.
Even the count 1-1. For his seventh multi-hit game today.
That's going to be trouble. Oh, what a
catch. Nice catch. And that makes it 2 outs coming and tracking way back. Rawlings. That's why he's in there, the defensive duty. Nice little web gem.
Man, that's a long run.
Actually, F4.
Yeah, wow.
Watch this. Ooh, oh. Nice, snow cone. Good play.
Glove was just big enough for that one.
Yeah, just enough to hold it in. 2 away, and Bell come to the plate. There's Mummert looking for a 1-2-3 inning. Got him even 1-1.
Big swing from Bell there.
Bell doubled, two RBI doubled back in, in the second. Flied out in the fourth. Inside, 2-2.
2-2.
Bell batting 333 coming in. That's going to drop. It is not.
Wow.
Read that well. He had him shaded a little short. Catch is made by Lopez. 1-2-3 go the Titans in the sixth. Take another look at the catch here from Lopez, who had him read.
Yeah, so two nice plays here. That's a good sliding catch there. Right after Rawlings made the nice catch. Some defense from Daytona State.
No runs, no hits, none left. Titans trail by 2. We go to the top of the 7th.
Come on, now you're on your way. Come on, like it, like that. Come on, now you're.
The biggest challenge that students have, I believe, is just getting started. That's why we're here at the Writing Lab, is to help show them how to pre-plan their writing, how to get a good start, and then go back and revise. And we're here for every step of that. I just like to see that little eureka moment, that light bulb that goes on, and they're like, oh, I know how to do this now. I help with any class that involves writing. If it's language-based, we can help.
See the scoreboard, 6-4. Titans trailing here, giving up four runs in the last two innings. They've been skunked themselves in the last two. And you and I were talking here in the break. You can't really allow any more now because it looks like the pitching is settled in for Daytona State.
Yeah, definitely. You've gotten to the point in the game where Daytona State's got their two good relievers that they can go to now. Mummert had a really good sixth. You imagine he's going to be in the seventh as well. So if you're Cordero, you got to match him at this point.
Now batting number 16, Scott Edwards.
And the Titans coming into this 20-20 and 11-13 in conference play have to make up some ground here if they want to make the postseason. Need every win as Edwards will start things off for Daytona State.
Cordero threw that one by him.
Edwards has struck out three times.
Yeah.
And on his way to a fourth.
Gotta think he's gonna get another one of those. Yep.
Got a piece of it at least. Upstairs, ball one.
Trying to see if he would chase another high ball.
Two, two.
Count even at 2-2. Chase here. Struck him out looking. So first strikeout registered by Cordero. Second. And fourth time set down via strikeout for Edwards. One away. Now Rawlings to the plate.
Yeah, Rawlings had a really good day when you look at a couple walks, scored a couple runs.
Takes a strike.
Made a great catch.
Right.
Out in right field.
Upstairs, 1-1.
Gotta think he might have earned himself another
right,
start.
Right, I think so. Serves his master well and he will be rewarded. And nearly pokes that one through, picked up by Mangual over to first. And in time, two away.
Good defensive play by Hector Mangual.
Titans could use a 1-2-3 inning here. Designated hitter back in, Grafmeyer for his second at bat. Walked and eventually came around to score in the last inning. Batting 247. Threw that one. 1-1. Catcher Janilla on deck. wearing his knee pads. Take those off quick if he does get a chance. Check swing. Two strikes. Two's across the board. Just missed.
Full count.
Full count. Home plate umpire Jason Morales saying as much. Ted Sunday is the field umpire. And the strikeout completed. Three up, three down. Two strikeouts there that inning for Cordero. And the Titans still down by two as we go to the home half of the seventh.
Yeah, another really good pitch from Anthony Cordero. Two strikeouts in a 1-2-3 inning. That's just what the Titans needed.
And they settled. They've settled it now, pitching in the defense. Now you got to do something offensively to get back in it.
Yeah.
Well, this game was started by Mr. Perry Zalen, who had a pretty good outing for the Scouts, you'd have to say. Left in a pretty good position.
Yeah, for sure. You know, the last two runs were a little unlucky. But overall,
struck
really
out,
good day.
Struck out six and was keeping them guessing throughout the game.
Oh. Yeah, they were definitely guessing on that one.
Unfortunately, we'll not be in position for any decision today.
There's Cordero scoring the run.
But working his way back from the injury, you'll take that?
Yeah, for sure. You know, five solid innings today. So he gets back into starter shape, you would think, now.
Bottom half of seventh now. Swinging away is Jake Cooper. Hit by a pitch, advanced to second in the second inning, flied out to right field in the fourth, so 0 for 1. Waits on that one, sends it deep to left, tracking back is... Yep, they got that.
Yeah, Parzich with a nice catch out there.
Fly to seven. Kevin Smith comes in. One away. Second inning of work for Wyatt Mummert. A lot of English on that fastball.
Come on.
Smith reached on a walk last time up, came around to score. Sends it deep to the wall. To the wall, it will be at least one base hit. Digging in for a double, and he's in there standing up. So a one-out double for Kevin Smith to get things started here for Eastern Florida in the seventh.
Yeah, really good swing by Smith there.
So if you got a hard thrower, if you can get it, it can go equally as hard the other way. So Davis, the bottom of the order, did get a single last at bat.
This will be interesting to see if...
And an RBI.
Coach goes for the small ball, or if he lets Smith try to steal third, maybe. Smith has stolen third quite a few times this year. Now he'll be off.
They're going to try to throw anyway, and it got away. Oh, and he's going to go. It wasn't backed up. And that will score a run, so the small ball works that time, putting a little bit of pressure on. And it cuts the lead to 6-5. How about that?
Yeah, and that's definitely the kind of ball that Coach Brown likes. Put some pressure on the defense, make them make an error, score some runs.
Stolen base, then error to score. Free run, basically.
Yeah, so just like that, a double turns into a run, and it's 6-5.
Davis will definitely swing away now, and it will poke that. right to right field. Lopez was in on it and made the catch easy, two away. Back to the top of the order. Here's a look again at what happens. It's just a little bit of a pass ball.
Ball didn't get away much. Smith took advantage. And then as soon as that ball was dropped at third, he was off.
Well, a pass ball, not necessarily a stolen base. Pass ball error.
Oh, yep. Punt.
Cranks at the center, and it will drop in for a base hit for Cordero. Two out single.
So now, much like Smith, have more speed on the bases. I would imagine you'll see Cordero try to steal second if he can now.
Right.
Coach going out to have a word with Hummer. Probably telling him the same kind of thing.
Right. He seems to have gotten the benefit of some walks and errors to get some scoring in.
Caden Brown warming up for Daytona. Caden Brown had a really good outing against Miami-Dade on Saturday. Looks like if they go away from Mummert, it'll be Brown first. Much like we were talking about with the Titans, Daytona State knows
right.
They have two tomorrow, so if they don't have to pitch everybody, they're hoping not to.
Mummer going after Cerrone. 0 for 2 with a sacrifice. Mummer will throw back. Always hated trying to steal against lefties. Hated that.
Yeah.
Looking right at you.
You can try to get in their head because they're looking at you, but at the same time, they can see
right
exactly what you're thinking.
Especially if they have a scowl on their face, like, yeah, I don't know about this. Down the line, foul ball. Got a couple more inches to the right.
I was just going to say that was close.
Say football is the game of inches, right? It matters in baseball, too.
So now Mummer has 0-2.
Again, the throwback. Got two outs and an 0-2 count on the batter. Not sure what I'd be worried about at the moment.
Yeah. Yeah, I really wouldn't pay this much attention to Cordero as much. I'd go after Cerrone here with two outs, 0-2 count.
Now come to the plate this time, upstairs. Just takes enough of attention off of what you're doing going to the plate.
It definitely does.
Again. It. Straight away, tracking and catching is Edwards, and that will do it. So a fly out the center ends the inning, but a run comes across, one hit, an error, and a pass ball. And it's 6-5 as we go to the top half of the eighth here in Melbourne.
Like it.
getting laid on here in Melbourne, going to the top of the eighth. Daytona State nursing a one-run lead here against Eastern Florida. Duck and cover. It's going to be a fun couple of innings.
Yeah, we saw that last inning, how quick the Titans can score if they get on base. So Cordero just has to have another strong inning here and hope they can get the bats going again.
9-1-2 in the order here for Daytona State for Tim Thoma's crew. Junilla will bat for the fourth time. He's 1-for-2, singled with an RBI back in the third, struck out in the fifth, walked and reached second on a pass ball in the sixth, and is even 1-1 here in the eighth inning.
Yeah, it's funny to say, but from the nine hole, he's really been kind of a catalyst for him. Gotten on base and
Ian Rawlings in the seventh hole. Yep.
Really gotten things started for the top of the lineup.
2-1. Come on in.
So these two teams tomorrow in Daytona Beach. That one fouled off to the right, out of play.
Doubleheader, first game seven innings. Second one's nine.
Okay, 7-9. Not a long trip if you want to go up there. More of a an urban environment in Daytona Beach at that field.
Yeah.
Not as wide open, a little more tight. Right next door to the facility where the women's soccer team won a national championship a couple of years ago.
Wow.
For Eastern Florida, and the strikeout is recorded. Be the fourth strikeout for Cordero.
Yeah, once again, he just too much on that fastball for him. Big first out.
Back to the top of the order. And this is Parzic. Immediately foul back, 0-1. Couple of singles to go with a strikeout and a flyout, so 2-for-4. A multi-hit game for the man from Tallahassee. The short, tough play coming for Mangual, and got him. Trying to go back-to-back 1-2-3 innings here now for Cordero. Nickel and dime your way back in it.
Having a quick meeting with O'Sullivan.
Both bullpens empty at the moment. Connor O'Sullivan, the freshman. A couple of singles to go with a walk and a ground out. Goes the other way off the screen. Outside, 1-1.
Keeping his hot streak going. Came in 5-11, got two more today.
Come in a little, not enough. Two balls and a strike. A 2-1 came in and missed. 3-1. On deck is Lopez. Count runs full.
Made sure he got strike two on that one.
Yeah, trying to go 1-2-3 here in the eighth. Cordero rocks and fires. Foul ball left side.
Good swing from O'Sullivan on that one. Just fouled it off.
And tries to go opposite field, foul ball. Good piece of hitting there. Good battle.
I was gonna say, one of the few good battles we've seen.
Come on, win it.
Today.
Go.
O'Sullivan making Cordero work a little bit here.
Oh, lost the bat. And how. The slow walk off the mound after that strikeout. His fifth strikeout. 1-2-3.
Yeah, that's
go the Falcons. 6-5 the score. Go to the home half of the eighth. Titans down a run.
The lab that EFSC respiratory program has is very up to date and had actually more stuff than some of the hospitals did. As a student here, you know, working with all that equipment definitely puts you at an advantage because when you're here for a semester and then you go out, you get to see it on real patients. The lab here is, I would say, above and beyond what you would need to see and what you need to know when you go out to your clinical sites.
Back at Bruce Bochy Field, got a good one. One-run contest going into the home half of the eighth. Titans trailing that 6-5 scoreline. But we'll have Mangual, Dominguez, and Lambert here due up. So the heart of the order. Going up against Mummert, third inning of work. And off to a good start with the strike is Mummert. And from Maryland. Hector 0-for-3 here. Could do something about that.
Definitely three of the Titans' more productive hitters.
Went down and got it to the gap in right center, but no problem for Edwards. Makes the catch. 0-for-4 now for Mangual. And now Dominguez with one out will come to the plate. Smooth operator with that home run to right field back in the third. Officially 1-for-3. Oh, that's some movement, but
yeah,
just wide. One and oh. Oh,
that's a good
hang off on that one. Took a little off, right down Broadway. That 1-1.
Two one.
Ahead of the count now for Dominguez. Miami man, and in New Orleans next year. Through that one, 2-2. Leads this team in home runs, doubles, and RBIs. 31 of them now after the home run. And takes the strike for the strikeout. Punched out there. Two down.
Slided.
Curveball.
The first strikeout for Mummert by my count.
Yeah.
Just on the corner.
Yeah, it's the one. Those are the ones that hurt. All right, Luke Lambert, double, scored back in the second.
You got more?
Yeah.
Grounded out, flied out, 1-for-3. Got all that. Just under it, though. Racing to make the catch. Unable to do so and left is Parzic. There'll be extra bases here for Lambert and a two-out double.
Yeah, Lambert never stopped running on that. As soon as it got by him, rounded first, went all the way to second.
All right, so.
Just off the end of the bat.
Runner in scoring position for Laheem Bell. Chance to tie the game here.
Looked like Parzic might get to it.
Time.
Bell, an RBI double back in the second, has fouled out or flied out twice since.
I was going to say, Lambert did his double. Let's see if Bell does his double and ties the game up.
Okay, there's activity in that bullpen, and now the pitching coach will come out and have a word.
He's looking, but he hasn't motioned yet. Yep.
And there he goes. Mummert's afternoon is done. Roth, Mummert, and now say, is that Caden Brown?
I think it is.
Number 11. A lefty. Caden Brown, the freshman out of Sarasota's Inspiration Academy, trying to be an inspiration here late on for Daytona State. 0-0 record, 4.02 ERA, 15.2 innings pitched, 11 walks, 15 strikeouts, now in his 17th appearance for the Falcons.
Definitely one of the guys they use later. Looks like he averages about an inning an outing.
And a big spot here with a one-run lead. That's some movement on that junk. Not the biggest pitcher, 5'9". So the release point will be a little lower than I think some
Definitely.
Of these guys are accustomed to. You got to keep that in mind. See if he's a guy that throws some junk.
Definitely looks like it. If his warm-up tosses or anything to what we're going to see.
And Laheem Bell will get the first look at him. 1-for-3. Big spot here with a runner in scoring position out at second base and two out. Well. And trying to drop the deuce in there for a strike, unable to do so.
Definitely was close. Bell took it.
Take that one for a strike. Let's see what he's got for a bit. 1-1. Outside.
2-1.
Missed again wide. Curve didn't break back in.
No, yeah, that's two that have been pretty wide.
Cooper on deck should Bell get on here. 3-1 count. I don't know if you take it here.
It's got to be your pitch if you're going to swing.
Outside, ball four. It's not his pitch. So, two-out walk. First batter faced by Caden Brown. Brings up Jay Cooper, redshirt sophomore, State College PA. Do some damage here with his bat. 0 for 2, hit by a pitch. He is due. Side, 1-1. I think you're right, Mike. Just make it your pitch.
It's.
Don't chase it. Yep, go down, poke it. Will it drop? It will not.
Oh,
so close. So, fly out to Lopez and right, and that ends the inning. Titans down to their final three outs, but got to play some defense here in the top of the ninth. 6-5 the score. All right, ninth inning here in Melbourne. Titans down a run. And I'd like to keep it that way as they go into the home half to try to get a late win.
Yeah, you know, we didn't think we were going to get this kind of game, but it's been a fun game. So we're down to the final outs here. Cordero looking to keep things right where it's at so the bats have a chance here in the bottom of the ninth.
Having a conversation with someone yesterday about broadcasters and biases and which broadcasters they don't like listening in whatever sport because they're biased. And my response is broadcasters aren't biased, but for one thing, for a good game.
Yeah.
You want a good game. You don't pull for teams.
No.
It doesn't work that way.
Yeah, you definitely
no matter
don't.
How many bad things you think they say about your players, they don't want a blowout. That's never good TV.
Nope. No, we want this excitement at the end.
And so we got it. We got exactly what we wanted.
One of the Titans' best pitchers on the mound against the top hitter for Daytona. That's what you want to see here in the ninth.
Xavier Lopez, his fifth at bat. 0 for 2 officially. Infield fly and walk. Gets a piece of that, but puts it foul.
I hit that one a long way. Got around a little too quick. I would have been in trouble if he hit the chalk with that one.
On deck is Cannizzaro, the shortstop. No heart of the order here. 3-4-5. Be faced by Cordero. Certainly earn everything this inning.
Yeah.
Low, 1-2.
A good pitch for 0-2, though. Usually he tries to get him to chase something, and that one was very close to strike three.
Gets a piece. It's going to be a tough chase. Nope, not so much. Davis had it played well, had it scattered. So fly out the left. Start out this ninth inning, one away.
Yeah, good strong start to the inning. Get Lopez out. But now you got Cannizzaro, and then Corbett behind him, so it doesn't get much easier.
Cannizzaro up for the fifth time. Struck out, flied out, singled and walked. 1 for 3. is that back? Ball and a strike. Cordero has struck out five, walked two. Has done the job. Keep the Titans close enough to the strike. Six runs, eight hits here for the Falcons. Two errors. Five runs, eight hits for the Titans.
Yeah, and those two walks were early. He's retired eight in a row now. Really taking control. Which is what fans have watched him all year. This is basically Anthony Cordero in a nutshell.
What he does.
That's why Jacksonville's going to love him.
Pops it up. Calling for it. And catching it is Kevin Smith, and there's two away. Corbett. And Brett extended that hit streak to 10 earlier this game back in the fourth.
We got two.
Actually, one for three with a sack fly. Put that one in play and threw the infield for a base hit. And that will extend the workload here for Cordero.
So Edwards coming up, just looking to make a little contact after the first four bats today.
Backing out of there, ball. First is Corbett. Edwards, strikeout victim four times. Do everything he can to put the ball in place.
Yep.
You don't get the golden. Do not want the golden.
Played a really good center field today, though.
Right.
Has definitely
still make your contributions, right?
Definitely made his contributions.
How's that one? One and two.
In a tough spot again here. One and two against Anthony Cordero.
Let's protect the plate. Don't want to go down looking. You don't want to go down looking if you're fly foul.
It's gonna get
the batting
out of play.
Cage area. Cordero ready. The 1-2.
Yeah.
Got him. Strikeout. And that will end the top half of the ninth. Three outs to go. Titans need a run. It's 6-5 Daytona State. That would be. All right, go to the bottom of the ninth. Down a run here, the Titans, with 8-9-1 in the order. Very imperative you turn it over here.
Yeah, for sure. You know, you lead off with Kevin Smith. Great at bat his last time up with the double. Stole the run.
Now batting number 26.
Yeah, one for two, Smith. It did score twice. Again, the double the last time up, as Mike said. That's the guy you want to get things started.
Yeah, it's like having a leadoff hitter up, actually.
Go. Go it up.
Aiden Brown still working. Gets a strike, one and one.
As far as he's going out, Lou? No, he's... A little more? No. Time.
Got something in his eye. Looks like Daytona has guys ready in the pen if they need. Sure, they're hoping Brown ends it.
It's extended, yeah.
Ball.
Upstairs, ball two.
Oh,
right
good
back
glove.
At Brown. And we'll get the out.
Whew. What a great play by Brown there. Just a reflex.
Goes 1-3, and there's one away. Wow. Good reaction.
Yeah,
just had the glove in the right place.
That's hit hard by Smith. Just a little unlucky.
Davis now 1-3. Oh. Singled. Now the RBI back in the fourth.
Ball.
Outside, 1-1.
No worry.
Got to get somebody on board here.
Had the RBI single back in the fourth.
Right down Broadway, 1-2. Tough take.
1-2.
Now he's really going to have to choke up a little bit and get ready to hit.
Ball.
Outside.
Good eye there.
2-2.
2-2.
Anything you can to get on base. That will work. Seeing eye single through the left center. Second hit of the game for Davis. He's done the job. One away, one on. We go to the top of the order. And Carlos Cordero will come on. So a player with some pop. Two home runs if you're thinking about it.
Be interested if they see, if they ask him to lay the butt down or if they let him swing away. Davis not really known to steal a lot of bases.
Oh, ball does not break.
Did not show bunt either though. So it looks like they might let Carlos hit here.
It was 2-3, also reached on an error. Just caught the inside corner on that one.
That ball just
Rambo,
dropped in.
Yeah. 1-1. Back. I think everybody was on that one.
The entire dugout said that all in unison.
A 1-1. Cordero watches it strike. Boy, that just hung there.
It did.
Now you got to swing at those. 1-2. God, it was like slow-mo waiting for it. Where does this ball start? Woof.
That's
two.
It's a very tight one to take if you're Cordero.
Do you think curveball here?
I would think he throws that again.
Nope.
Bouncing
Pop the
ball.
Third. Could end the game here on a double play. Unable to get it safe at first. So the lead runner, Davis, erased on the fielder's choice.
Now batting number
And the Titans, though, down to their final out, but the runner's still at first.
So now with two outs, oh, they're going to have a chat. I would imagine this will be a quick chat with Brown, just to... Like we were talking about earlier, two outs, you know, how much attention do you really pay to Cordero?
Right.
Or do you just try to get the hitter out? I'm sure that's what he's kind of talking to Brown about right now.
Cerrone, 1-for-3 with a sacrifice. Batting .302 coming in, does have a couple of triples and a home run. 21 RBIs. A guy that can do some damage. And has got a chance for his moment now.
Good.
Strike one. If you want something to drive, it's going to have to be the, it's hard to drive a looping curve.
It really is.
Look at that. Throw to first. 0-1 here on Cerrone. And these two teams will play a doubleheader tomorrow in Daytona Beach. Caden Brown trying to close it out. Takes another strike and he's in an 0-2 hole.
Two really good pitches from Brown there.
Daytona State had lost 8 in a row before their last matchup. Got a win on Saturday. Looking for 2 in a row here. And it's through to left. Unable to make the play at third was O'Sullivan. 2 on now, but 2 out. So a single for Cerrone, that brings up Mangual, who is due, 0-for-4.
Mangual's been one of our best hitters this season. He was the Region 8 Player of the Week on March 25th. So this is a good guy for Coach Brown to have up here in this spot.
Did have the RBI on the ground out in the third. Big spot here. First one's what you need to keep this game going.
Brown was one pitch away. Starting over here. It's a good pitch.
Got some movement on that. Snapped it. 0-1.
Definitely a good mix from Mummer to him.
Low ball. 1-1. The 1-1. Swung at the curveball. Chopper gathered, thrown to first, and this one is over. Daytona State holds on. 6-5, the final score. They improve to 15-22 and 7-18 in conference play. Titans drop to 11-14, 20-21 overall. Missed opportunity, but the best part about baseball, you always got the next game the next day. You got two more for the Titans. We'll be back, wrap it up right after this.
My name is Kenny Neff, and I am enrolled in the Eastern Florida State College welding program. The cost of it actually surprised me on how it wasn't nearly what I thought it would be. My instructors are probably the best instructor I could probably ask for. Your total welding throughout the day, you're probably welding 4 hours, 5 hours. When the weekend comes, I'm waiting for Monday to come back around because I love welding, just being in there, hands-on, just constantly burning rods.
The engineering technology program is a 2-year AS degree. It's a lot of hands-on, a lot of industry skills, and our programs are up to date with the local demand. We talk to the local industry and ask them what do they need from our graduate. And so far, we're providing a good workforce for the Brevard area. When the student graduate from this program, actually, we have a waiting list. A lot of companies want some of our graduates yesterday.
Well, the Titans come up a run short here on Friday afternoon at Bruce Bochy Field. 6-5, the final Daytona State. Of course, first game of three. They'll play two again tomorrow at Daytona State. Now kind of a really must-win. You got to kind of sweep that doubleheader if you want to hope to make the postseason.
Yeah, really. It puts them a little bit behind us. You know, the good news is Kenneth Robinson's been very good for the Titans. He goes game one tomorrow, coming off a no-hitter against Polk State, who's one of the better teams in the conference. But, yeah, now they have to win both tomorrow. But today, you know, today kind of showed Roth, Mumrath, and Brown, nothing like the ERA coming in. They were very good today.
Right. Positive, Zaylin Perry had some good innings, got some work, got some good looks, and he's the one going to continue to get better as the season comes to an end.
For sure. You know, it's always good to have your number one starter back. Titans saw that today, got five innings out of him. You know, Anthony Cordero is Anthony Cordero. It'll be interesting to see if he has anything for tomorrow, but maybe they won't need him.
Possibly. You hope you're in that position when you jump up early. So the Titans, again, now a little behind schedule now as far as making the postseason, but they still have it in their control. Got to get some wins tomorrow for sure.
Yeah.
Next Tuesday, you and I will be just going across the street over across the way to the softball field, and we're going to see Shelby Pettick's team, at least I will, for the first time this season. What are we in for?
Yeah, the softball team's very, very fun to watch. Two good pitchers, Hannah Strickland, Alana O'Brien, very good. Offensive juggernaut. They can do it all. They play small ball as well, but they also can hit doubles, triples. They run wild. You know, Jenna Borky has 40 stolen bases, so it's always fun to watch when she gets on base. She's always a threat. So it should be a good doubleheader. Miami-Dade's played really well lately. So always a fun series with Miami-Dade anyway. They're an old rival
right.
for us.
Two against the Sharks, doubleheader live Tuesday on WEFS. Make sure you join us for that. Here at Bruce Bochy Field, the Titans fall 6-5 to Daytona State. We'll see them. We got one more baseball broadcast before we go away, so hopefully they're in that position to make the postseason when we get to that one for sure. So appreciate everybody watching. Nice working with you here, Mike. Good stuff. So for Mike Parsons and for Brian Foster, our producer and director, and the rest of our wonderful crew for WEFS, thanks so much for watching. We will see you Tuesday over at the softball field. I'm Jeff Radcliffe saying so long. Have a great weekend, everybody.
We now join our programming in progress.